From some of the panelists, I sort of get an impression that there is a desire to seek some sympathy investment in social sector. Now, if we, my views are that if we peel off just top few layers of this altruistic motives, ultimately color the money is the same. And therefore, what Rashesh and Pradeep mentioned, that actually it's a question of our positioning, that if I may use the term social entrepreneur for the time being, is seeking competing for the funds from the same sources from where the commercial enterprises are competing. And I think competition is not too tough. If you look at the statistics, their track record is nothing great where a social entrepreneur cannot compete. It's a question of how does one present the case so that the investor finds it worth its while. How to make oneself attractive is really the issue, rather than seeing why impact investor is not coming. I think the issue should be other way, that what do we do to make investors come to us? And this, in my opinion, this impact word is relevant only to a limited extent. It's not very significant.
Yeah, absolutely. Which I think
The only woman who has raised her hand so far, so I'm tempted to be partial. Oh, there's another
one. Good morning. I'm Sumita Ambasta. I run a philanthropic foundation called Flowering Tree. In my experience, what I hear from all of you, is kind of true. The question is of reciprocity of value. How does one make a case? And how does one listen to what the other person wants? I don't think Indian investors are missing at all. There are plenty. The question of impact is the entrepreneur's interest. It's not the investor's interest. The investor's interest is to make money. I think there's a lot of confusion about how do we find a reciprocity of value. If we can find that common space, I don't think investors would be missing. There's one more thing I just want to add to that. What I see here is areas like water, education, which is where government should be doing work. And a lot of private people are trying to do the work of the government, is where this confusion would be larger. I don't know if you all agree with that. This confusion is larger because the government's not doing. So we really should be asking, is government doing its job in
that's
the large impact areas?
And that's where the next question of standards and regulation may come in.
So actually, we do know the government is not doing stuff where it needs to do, that it needs to do in a lot of places. We don't consider that necessarily a problem. We think that's an opportunity. As long as you can build a sustainable business out there, it's a wonderful opportunity. Why would you not take up that option?
My question is to Pradeep. You mentioned that there's no really difference in terms of the investment, whether it is social or otherwise kind. But will it be fair enough if you say that social enterprise could focus on something which is job creation or economic development in the rural sector or semi-urban? Because if you see the kind of people who are represented in Sankalp Forum are largely focused on the semi-urban and the rural sector, largely agriculture.
Turn around and say, I would believe there are more poor people in Bombay than in Latur district.
Absolutely.
What
the
is
point is that if you are
urban.
Able to create jobs in the rural sector, you will not have slums in Bombay or Bangalore. As simple as that. I mean, it's like the migration is happening because there's no job opportunities or economic independence out in the in those two areas.
So I don't think you'll find an investor interested in solving the problem of migration, right? We're interested in solving more investment-based,
yeah, but
IRR-based
if, issues. If the investment happens at level that it would.
Hi, my name is Sean. This is a question to the panel, and it's about how do we increase the social value to the investor? Bill Gates, after he made his money, didn't start tackling malaria to make more money. He made it so he could say that he cured malaria.
It's actually priceless, and it's already starting, Sean. You see, on our own panel, Rohini and her husband, they've started it. You have Shiv Nader started it. So it has to start from somewhere. Indians have started making money now in the last decade. In the US and Europe, people have been making money for years. We didn't hear Warren Buffett give money in the 70s or 80s. It's all happened in the last two or three years when he said, I'll give it all up. And it'll happen faster. Indians are generally tend to jump, whether it be technology, whether it be phones, it'll be philanthropy. We'll jump it and do it, and you'll see that in the next couple of years, people like the Ambanis and other people will also start giving up big money. But they don't want someone to push them. They don't want someone to come and tell them what to do. That's why they didn't show up for these meetings when Warren came and Bill came. They'll do it. They know what to do. And it'll guarantee in the next 5 years it'll happen.
So actually, Sasha, from
I'll just add one small thing. I think it's easier to do in philanthropy. I think, it's very clear because there is no commercial objective when you're giving money for a good cause. And there are areas which need philanthropic capital for sure because they cannot be commercially viable. I think the confusion happens again is when you're trying to achieve commercial objectives and then making the trade-off saying, okay, I also want to feel good, but I also want to earn the returns. And that is a lot harder to do.
Actually, Rohini, I think there's an interesting thing. If we were to give a Nobel Prize to Sharad Pawar, a lot of money will go back to the rural India. Huge amount of money will go back to the social sector. I'm being half facetious or so.
Okay. We
I'm not going to be invited back to a panel again.
I think the good thing is that anybody thinks that the investors are missing. So we have solved the case.
Thank you.
Thank you.